Hello, I'm Juliane Kleiner, working in the nutrition unit of EFSA, and I'm here to explain how health claims are assessed. So what is a health claim? A health claim is any statement on labels that suggest a food brings a health benefit, such as boosting your immune system or reducing body weight. Since 2006, we have an EU-wide regulation in place which require that any health claim made on food should be scientifically justified in order to protect consumers from inaccurate or misleading information. The role of EFSA, and in particular of its scientific panel on nutrition, dietetic products and allergies, is to review the science behind all these claims. So how does EFSA perform this task? In assessing each claim, EFSA's nutrition experts focus on three main criteria. The first criteria is the food or food ingredient properly defined for a claimed effect? For example, a claim on weight reduction might be proposed for all dairy foods like yogurt, milk, and cheese products. This food category would not be sufficiently defined for such a claim, as there are so many different types of dairy products on the market which may have different nutritional compositions, like full fat, low fat, sugared or not, which could have different effects on body weight, depending on their composition. But yogurts with a specific composition could be sufficiently characterized. The second criteria is the claimed effect properly defined? For example, a claim stating that food X improves your body shape is too unspecific for scientific evaluation, as you would not know what to look at. But a claim stating that a food helps to reduce your body weight, this would be sufficiently defined because body weight can be measured. If criteria 1 and 2 are met, then the expert looks at all the data available to see whether there is sufficient evidence to substantiate the claim. In this context, human intervention studies are crucial for the evaluation of whether the claim can be scientifically proven, but also other studies can provide useful, supportive evidence, for example, on how this could work. The studies need to address the defined food. In our case, it would be the yogurts with a defined composition and the right outcome, which would be, in our case, weight reduction. At the end, the panel looks at the number of studies in favor and not in favor for the claim, also taking into account the quality of the studies and the plausibility of the claim, and then weighs the overall evidence to come to a conclusion. The conclusion can be positive, which means that the panel is convinced that there is sufficient evidence to substantiate the claim, or negative, which could mean that there is either some but not convincing evidence, or there is only poor evidence. For example, no human study at all to prove the effect. On the basis of EFSA's scientific work, the European Commission and Member States decide on whether or not to authorize a claim.